So this is the companion video to the one where we ran the program. So I wanted to show you the flowchart to help also kind of visually understand the difference between the three loops. So let's look at the while loop first. So we have our initial declaration of a variable that we're going to use in the conditional. So we have int I equals 0. We have our conditional test. So in the flowchart, we would represent this conditional test with a diamond, just like we would with an if statement. If that conditional is true, then we go and run the statements. So the statements would be these two statements that we have here, the cout and the I++. And then it would then go back to the beginning and go through the basically like an if test again, go through and run the conditional again and see if it's true. And so as long as it's true, it just keeps looping around. So it's very similar to an if statement, except that it continues to come back around, whereas an if statement, you would just run through it once. And then once your conditional fails and it becomes false, then you exit the loop and you go on with the rest of your code. Let's take a look at the do while. So with the do while, the statements are executed first. Then, so that would be the cout statement and then the J++. Then the conditional is executed, is J less than 10. If true, then it executes the statements again and then tests. Executes the statements again and then tests. Once the conditional becomes false, then it goes ahead and runs the rest of your code again. So notice how similar these are, but notice that the key difference is with the while loop, the test is before the statements. With the do while loop, the test is after the statements are already run once. So think about using a do while loop if you ever need a loop that's going to go ahead and run the statements once, even if the test is false, because the test doesn't get run until after the statements are run. And then the for loop, of course, it looked complicated. And there's several different ways that we can do for loops. But again, the for loop is nice because everything's all within this one block. So with the for loop, what's coming in is here with our program, and it's hitting that first part of the for loop, int k is equal to 0. So it's setting up the variable that you're using. Then from here, it flows into the rest of our program. So it flows then into, is k less than 10. So if that's true, then it runs the statements, but it doesn't come all the way back up here again. It just runs the increment or decrement that you have at the end of your for statement. And then once it runs that, then it flows back into the test and tests, runs the statements again, flows right back up into this increment or decrement, and then tests again. So this initialization only happens once, but the increment happens as many times as the loop happens, and the test is going to happen as many times as the loop happens, plus one final test that'll then give you a false, and then when it's false, then you just go ahead and run the rest of your code. Thanks for watching.